Hedy Lamarr, or as she was once known, Hedwig Eva Maria Kiesler, was born in Vienna on November 9, 1914. Growing up, she spent a lot of time with her father, who would take her on long walks where he would explain how everything worked, from printing presses to streetcars. These warm memories of her father's enthusiasm for technology instilled in her a lifelong interest in invention. Hedy was also well known for her beauty, so at 16 years old, she was discovered by a director named Max Reinhardt, who saw her potential in the movie industry. After that, she landed roles in The Trunks of Mr. OF, No Money Needed, and Ecstasy. At 18, she married Friedrich Mandel, a wealthy military arms dealer who did business with Nazi manufacturers. They hosted luxurious parties with guests like Adolf Hitler and Benito Mussolini, and Friedrich would bring Hedy to some of his business meetings. During these meetings, she would learn about military and radio technology, something that would be crucial later on in her life. Despite Friedrich's lavishness, he was so paranoid that Hedy would cheat on him that he kept her confined and prevented her from pursuing her acting career, making her feel trapped in a golden prison. Hedy knew she had to make changes, so she moved to Paris, where she met Louis B. Mayer, a talent scout. He offered her a really bad deal, so she turned him down, because she knew her own value and was not willing to settle for less. Despite this, Hedy was still intrigued as to where this might take her, so she bought a ticket for the same ship that Louis was taking to America, bargained a better deal, and changed her name. Despite finding success in America with a steady stream of films, she was often typecasted as a stunningly gorgeous woman with few lines, which made her feel unsatisfied. This is when she turned to inventing, coming up with ideas like an improved spotlight, a better Kleenex box, a new traffic signal, and a tablet that supposedly would create a Coca-Cola-like soda when dissolved in water. The beverage was unsuccessful. Hedy herself said it tasted like Alka-Seltzer. In 1940, amidst World War II, Hedy was horrified to hear that German submarines were torpedoing cruise liners carrying children to safety. She felt compelled to invent something to help the Allied cause, so she chose to focus on torpedoes. Hedy had previous exposure to their technology because of the dinner parties she attended with Friedrich, where German technical specialists would discuss their torpedo and submarine problems. The biggest problem facing American torpedoes was their accuracy rate. Over 60% of them would fail, either diving too deep, exploding too early, or just doing nothing. Hedy thought the torpedoes should be controlled using radio signals, but unfortunately, these signals were easy to intercept and jam by the enemy, which could be dangerous. So, she came up with an idea to make the radio signal jump around from frequency to frequency at a fairly fast rate, making it difficult to jam since the enemy would never know what signal to block. The key was to have the torpedo and the spotter plane synchronize right before firing, and then change frequencies independently on a predetermined basis. Hedy referred to this as frequency hopping, and it was very similar to using a remote control to quickly change channels. Now, both the torpedo and the spotter plane could prevent classified information and message transmissions from being intercepted by the enemy. Hedy wasn't sure how to demonstrate this until she met an avant-garde composer named George Antheil, who was known for his attempts to coordinate the playing of 16-player pianos. In his experimentation, he learned how to use punch tape to tell a piano which key to play. By adapting this idea to torpedoes, they developed the secret communication system, and in 1942, they applied and were granted a patent for it. However, when Hedy and George presented it, the US Navy didn't want to invest more money into technology that they didn't really understand, so it wasn't adopted. The patent was classified top secret and remained untouched for years. Her frequency hopping idea wasn't implemented until 1962, during the Cuban Missile Crisis. Because it was such a tense moment in history, it was absolutely crucial that ship-to-ship radios and control systems for missiles weren't jammed. Once technology was declassified in the 1980s, it quickly became the precursor to many wireless technologies we use today. Cell phones, GPS, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, wireless cash registers, barcode readers, the list goes on. Thanks to Hedy and George, these communications could be shared securely and without interference. Hedy was unique because she didn't want to profit from her invention. She gave the patent to the US Navy and regarded it as her contribution to the war effort. But she did want to be recognized, especially because she always felt like no one in Hollywood ever thought she was intelligent. More than 50 years after Hedy filed her patent, the Electronic Frontier Foundation granted her the EFF Pioneer Award, to which she responded, "Well, it's about time."